Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, in a probably very unflattering attitude here, doing a grand experiment tonight. I have an Edison Standard D with a shaved black wax cylinder, and I have my recording horn. This is the one I use for recording voice. And as you can see, I've got it butted against a Victor Victrola VVIV. And we're going to try to record off of a cylinder, off of a disc onto a cylinder. This is the Lindbergh record. I put a new needle in a very loud reproducer on the Victor machine. I'm going to close the doors and cover the opening with a heavy towel. And I'll probably be holding this in position as this records. So it's going to be interesting. I've never tried this before. It's going to be interesting to see the effect, if it works, how it works. Also, I'm recording on a black wax cylinder. Not the best medium to record on, but better than nothing. And it gives you a chance to experiment, which is exactly what I'm doing. The machine is fully wound. Edison machine is fully wound. I don't know if this is going to work. If it does, what kind of cylinder, what kind of recording it's going to make, I have no idea. I've never done this before. So this is truly a grand experiment. So, I guess without further ado, we'll start both machines and see what happens. As soon as I drop the stylus on the Edison machine, the recording will start. I'm using a 1905 recorder with a small lead weight that's been installed in the stylus. As soon as I drop the stylus on the recording, I will start the record. No idea what's going to happen here. See it from this angle, actually seeing the recorder cutting the cylinder. All right, I guess. Put the recorder back in its box to make sure nothing happens to it. These things are worth their weight in gold. And I'll just swing the camera over. If this works, I will, of course, do a a better rendition. But it definitely cut the cylinder. But as I said, how it's going to turn out, I have no idea. Recorded on black wax. But I've had pretty good luck with this recorder on this machine. And one thing that's really strange is these recorders are identical, or virtually identical. They were all handmade, of course. The thing is, some of these recorders will not work on some Edison machines. This recorder with the weighted stylus will not work on my Edison home phonograph, and yet it works perfectly on the standard D, and it works perfectly on a standard C. It does not, however, work on a standard B. So there's dimensional differences in the machines themselves. How they address that, I have no idea. I assume, since these are shaved, I assume that a full-size wax cylinder, any recorder on any machine will probably cut it. Once you've shaved it and you've changed the dimensions, that no longer holds true. Because a new brown wax cylinder is much thicker than a shaved any cylinder, especially black wax. All right, brush the swarf off. Now, the grand experiment. I have no idea what this is going to sound like. I don't know if it worked at all. It recorded. What it recorded, I have no idea. So let's replace the Model C reproducer. We'll turn the machine around so you can see it. Install a brass witch's hat horn. Just going to leave the machine here. Put the cylinder back on. Now, as I said, I have no idea what kind of recording this is going to make. This is always the moment of truth. You never know. Let's back this up so you guys can see it a bit. If this works, I will make a better recording, obviously. I'll make a better video as well. Cylinder, and if I had used a bigger horn, I think I could have made a really decent recording. So, in any case, it was a quick experiment, and as I said, this is a very undignified video, forgive me, but this is the only place I had enough room to do this. So, if you have any questions, comments on this very unique Vitrola Guy video, feel free to drop me an email. I answer all my emails. I try to answer them the day I get them. TheVitrolaGuy@gmail.com. Recording from a disc machine to an Edison 2-minute machine with interesting results. It worked, not great, but an excellent start. So, the Vitrola Guy, gmail.com, and as always, thank you for watching.